Hello and welcome to the Catenion Webinar Series. My name is Mayur Vadwani and I am a consultant at Catenion, a science-driven strategy consulting firm for the biopharma industry. At Catenion, we leverage our science and technology expertise to develop strategies to help our clients drive innovation and bring new treatments to the market. Today, we'll talk about the field of psychedelics and dwell a bit deeper into the opportunities and challenges in this space. What are psychedelics? Psychedelics are molecules that modulate the brain function and often trigger so-called trips, a temporary altered state of consciousness, often associated with the activation of serotonergic signaling in the brain. In fact, classical psychedelics such as psilocybin, MDMA, LSD, DMT are molecules that exert their effect by activation of the serotonergic pathway. In contrast, ketamine is more of a dissociative anesthetic that acts on the NMDA receptor. Whether ketamine is a psychedelic is currently being debated. While academia has raised doubt about the compound's touted psychedelic effect, investors have welcomed ketamine and its dissociative psychedelic-like effect as a gateway drug into the new business ecosystem. So, for the purpose of this talk, we'll include ketamine along with other classical psychedelics to understand the space from multiple lenses. The field of psychedelics has undergone a major transformation in the last few years. In the mid-1900s, initial studies describing the synthesis of LSD and isolation of psilocybin from magic mushrooms were reported. Due to an increase in abuse of this class of molecules, a Controlled Substances Act was signed by the US President Nixon in 1970. This classified psychedelics, psilocybin, LSD, and mescaline as Schedule I drugs, curtailing the research for the next three decades. Between 2000 and 2015, a second wave of psychedelic research was observed. Institutions such as UCLA and Johns Hopkins University were leading the investigator-initiated trials to study the effect of psychedelics in psychiatric disorders. The outcome of these studies, although limited with their trial size and design, instigated both the regulators and the investors. In fact, in 2017, FDA granted to MAPS the first breakthrough designation for MDMA-assisted therapy in PTSD. This was followed by another breakthrough for psilocybin in 2018 and 19 for depression to Compass Pathways and Usona Institute, respectively. Another milestone in this field was observed with the approval of intranasal ketamine in 2019. Last year, positive efficacy outcome was reported by MAPS and Compass Pathway from their MDMA and psilocybin studies. In terms of number of publications, there was a first wave in 1950s and 60s with several clinical articles published discussing the efficacy of LSD. A decline in research was seen after the Controlled Substances Act was signed. A second wave started in early 2000s, this time encompassing several psychedelic drugs, with a major peak in last couple of years. A change in funds granted by NIH also reflects the changing perception in the field. Overall, we have seen over 100% increase in funds granted by NIH in the last 10 years, dominated primarily by ketamine and MDMA. The year 2021 also saw a fourfold increase in grants awarded by the NIH for psilocybin research as compared to the previous year. In addition, a $4 million NIH grant was awarded to the investigators at the Johns Hopkins University for the first clinical trial of psilocybin for the treatment of tobacco use disorder, reflecting an increased interest from the research perspective. Psychiatric disorders are highly prevalent and affect over 900 million individuals worldwide. It also imposes a significant economic burden on the society. Although there are several drugs that have been approved for a range of psychiatric disorders, particularly major depressive disorder, a high unmet need is still reflected based on the real-world data, with a small proportion of patients responding to the treatment. In a STAR-D study that analyzed over 3,600 depression patients undergoing antidepressant treatment, it was reported that almost half of the patients did not achieve a response with the first line of antidepressant therapy, while three quarters of the patient did not achieve a response with a second line of antidepressant therapy. There are multiple drugs that have been approved so far, and most of them are blockbuster franchises for the pharma companies. But this space has seen a large innovation gap in the last decades. To illustrate with an example here, there are only two approved therapies for post-traumatic stress disorder, Zoloft and Paxil. These were approved back in 1999 and 2000, and we haven't seen any approval for this particular indication over the last two decades. One of the recent additions to the list of approved drugs is intranasal ketamine, a fast-acting antidepressant that was approved by the FDA in 2019 for major depressive disorder. Its approval has rekindled the interest of investors in old psychedelic drugs. In the last 2 years, biotechs have raised over $850 million in venture financing, with companies such as Atai, GH Research, Compass Pathways, Beckley Psytech, and Delix raising a significant round of VC fund. In addition, we have seen almost a 200% increase in equity offering in 2021 versus the previous year, a total amounting to over $1 billion in both the years. Among the top public biotechs operating in this space, we have seen a majority of biotechs going public in 2021 with a relatively short runway time from their founding to IPO. Over the last decade, interventional clinical trials with psilocybin, MDMA, and DMT have been gaining momentum. While ketamine accounted for almost 50% of the investigator-initiated studies in 2021, there is a shifting trend observed within the industry-sponsored trials, with psilocybin, MDMA, and DMT coming more into the limelight. A number of biotechs have emerged in this space, focusing on one or more psychedelics. Some of the key clinical and preclinical stage biotechs are listed here. As we can see, most of the companies focus on psilocybin, ketamine, and DMT, while a smaller number of companies focus on other psychedelics like MDMA, LSD, and ibogaine. These biotechs are in fact focusing on a range of psychiatric disorders, with a major focus on depression, anxiety, and substance abuse disorders. As we can see here, most psychedelics are in early stage clinical trials across indications, with psilocybin being studied in the largest number of indications. In November 2021, Compass Pathways announced top-line result from its phase 2B trial investigating psilocybin-assisted therapy for treatment-resistant depression. Although positive efficacy outcomes were reported, the market reacted negatively to this readout. Clearly, investors are seeking more than just efficacy with this class of drugs. So let's examine the parameters that pose a challenge for development and commercialization of psychedelics. There is data to demonstrate rapid and sustained effects of psychedelics. In fact, Spravato is considered as a real breakthrough for treatment-resistant depression patients with suicidal ideation. It has demonstrated a positive outcome in those difficult-to-treat patients within 24 hours of treatment, which is a game-changer in the field. Additionally, rapid and sustained effects is also demonstrated by psilocybin and a positive outcome reported from an MDMA phase 3 study. Although the data from these trials have been encouraging, efficacy data from placebo-controlled double-blinded studies with larger number of participants remains to be seen. In terms of safety, psychedelics are generally considered safe, although some critics argue that these molecules may carry an abuse potential. Even though there are concerns over safety, the data is closely being monitored and long-term safety data from controlled clinical trials is still awaited. There are several research and developmental challenges that lie on the road to psychedelic development. A major hurdle has been patient recruitment. According to a report published by Vargas and colleagues in 2021, over 95% of the patients screened for psilocybin trials did not meet the inclusion criteria. Majority of the patients had comorbid cardiovascular or mental health risk that could be potentially worsened by psychedelics and hence were excluded from the trial. Another key challenge has been an optimal design of a truly placebo-controlled double-blinded study because of the profound subjective experiences observed with psychedelics and the fact that the exact role of placebo in overall efficacy of psychedelic-assisted therapy has not been established. Additional challenges revolve around dose-response relationship as well as the duration of the psychotherapy sessions. Both are essential to better understand the treatment strategies for the patient in real-world setting. Several challenges also revolve around intellectual property protection and public perception. On one hand, with IP, limited expertise and inadequate knowledge of these substances, as well as the history of indigenous and underground use could result in issuance of suboptimal patents. Additionally, biopiracy of indigenous technologies without adequate permission, acknowledgement, or compensation is likely if there are no clear ethical or legal guidelines. On the other hand, a negative image is associated with the psychedelics, and this perception has stayed since several decades. Although reforms are being undertaken in this direction, this could be a rather slow process. There are very limited regions where psychedelics are either legal or decriminalized. In the United States, Oregon was the first state to legalize psilocybin-assisted therapy in 2020 and was recently announced that the state will widely legalize psychedelics starting 2023. The state of New York is following the suit and is planning to introduce reforms to initiate psychedelic-assisted therapies for war veterans and the non-responder to current therapies. The treatment setting for psilocybin-assisted therapy requires the presence of a team of two professional therapists to supervise the therapy, and hence the analysts predict the cost to remain a major concern if the therapy is approved with current settings. This also puts an additional economic burden to set up the facilities to cater to a larger patient population. To avoid hallucinogenic effects observed with classical psychedelics, biotechs are also focusing on non-hallucinogenic psychoplastogens that have a potential to eliminate the need to treat patients in the clinic. Although this could greatly expand the access to the therapies to the patients, they are yet to demonstrate an efficacy in the target population. As a part of our methodology, when analyzing the psychedelics field, we also assess the hype cycle. From our analysis, we can see that psychedelics have been hyped since 2018. However, the majority of the technology is still lagging behind. There is much we do not know yet in this field. For example, what kind of formulations, which routes of administration, and the treatment duration would yield the best efficacy result. That's why, moving forward, the clinical readouts from 2022 and 2023 will be key to field's future. We hope that this has made you excited about the psychedelics field, and we look forward to telling you more about it in the future. That concludes today's Catenion webinar. Thank you for watching. Check out our other webinars and publications on our website and the YouTube channel. Follow us on LinkedIn for our latest updates and send us an email if you want to get in touch with us. See you next time.